For any conflict, see here, which leads to war, there could be two types of reasons. See, generally, as soon as we see people, we don't go and fight with them. Suppose if I have any personal issue or grudge with them, and which is catalyzed with some other issue at that moment of time, then I get motivated, go and attack somebody or do something. So, general reasons are there. And specific reasons are there for any issue. So, for a conflict or war, we will have two types of reasons. The first one is general, second one is immediate. The general reasons will be the base reasons for get any issue to be diverted. The immediate reason is like a issue which rises, all the general things automatically gets bounded up because of this. It is like a solution in which a chemical is added for that, then you get the bulge output or it gets pounded out. So it's like a catalyst. It is like because of this they have, they are forced to take some action against the others. That is the immediate reason and some general reasons. So, for our world wars also, the World War I and World War II also we have the same category of the reasons. Let us see first what are the immediate reasons that we have for World War I first one. See, the immediate reason for World War I is the Archduke King of Austria went to Serbia on an official trip. Francis went to Serbia with his wife named Sofia on an official trip. He went there, who is the natural heir of Austria, means the person who is going to be the king of Austria went here to get the some official visit. He went on his personal works. Then on the official visit, when he went with his family, he was attacked by the fanatics of Bosnian Serb. Bosnia is the name of a region which was controlled by Austria. There are some Balkan states or peninsular regions which are controlled by Austria. Some of the group people who revolted against the king wanted to teach a lesson to him. So they revolted the ruling system, what is happening in the Balkan politics. They killed the ruler Frank and his wife Sofia, literally and very brutally they were killed. When they were killed very brutally during this period, the Austrian government served the ultimatum for Serbia. This incident happened on 1914. The Serbian government does not have any idea of the people who have done this incident. So now Austrian government thought that Serbia is supporting the people of Bosnians to do war against them. Because of this misunderstanding of Austrian government against Serbia, they served the ultimatum that they have to respond within 48 hours. If not, we are going to take action against the issue or we are going to attack the nation. Serbia, instead of giving answer, as they were backed by the other nations, they revolted to respond to this one. So immediately the World War I was declared by Austria against Serbia. So in support of Serbia, we got the hand of Russia. Then in support of this, we got France. In support of the other side, we got the Britain. While in support of Austria, we got Germany, Italy. So here we got one group, there we got one group. The issue became an international issue now. We can't stop the war. The war went on to a serious level. So this is the catalytic reason or the main reason which triggered the World War I, which was fought for nearly 4 years and which was a drastic war which the human mankind has ever seen until this period. So it raised to various issues and questions of during this period. And what is the basic or immediate reason for World War II? See here, for World War I, it is a reason, a solid reason. For World War II, by the time the ruler of Germany was Hitler. Ruler of Germany was Hitler. And the Germany was divided into two parts. Germany was divided into two parts. In the middle, the region is called as Polish Corridor. Understand the point clearly here. Germany was ruled by Hitler during that period. And Germany was divided into two parts. The middle region was called Polish Corridor. Means this is a cut face key, a division between the two parts of Germany. Germany is East Germany and West Germany. Middle we have a land piece or Danzig called the Polish Corridor, controlled by Poland. Hitler want to annex this Polish Corridor and interlink East Germany and West Germany together and form a new boundary for Germany. At the same time, he thought it would be a small expansion of his foreign policy and military policy. This is the basic blunder what Hitler has thought, that it would be a very small military expansion as per his calculations. Yes, military or economically he is very strong. He is capable of fighting the war at that moment. This incident happened on 1939. As soon as Hitler started to attack the Poland or the Polish Corridor, England supported the Poland to resist against that, and immediately we got the support of Russia backing Poland and questioning the authority of Hitler. So in order to sustain this, and as he had tie-ups with the Germany and Italy and all these nations, these people came in support of Germany to sustain the war. So automatically again we got, on 1st September, the issue was declared into war. The catalytic force or the main reason for the establishment of Second World War is the Hitler invading Polish Corridor. The First World War is Austria giving ultimatum for Serbia on the issue of Archduke Francis, who was murdered. So these two were the main issues which generated the wars of World War I and World War II. Now let us see the other issues which have brought these things. What are the binding forces that made them to go for the this world war? See, we have two groups here. Again, two groups here. What are the two groups called? The Axis powers, Allied powers. Now, when Germany got independence in 1879, who got independence?
Germany. Same time we got independence for Italy also, and partially Austria also was independent.
So to check the growth of Italy falling into the hands of France, and to control England's influence in the middle region, Germany agreed to make agreements with these two, or secret agreements with these two, and came with a triple alliance
which was founded in 1879 to 1882.
Then within few days England broke down its barriers and came friendship with Russia
and USA form the triple entity.
So naturally we got two power blocks rising as per their nationalism inspirations. See here, as soon as Germany became independent and Italy became independent, they started to block the other nations getting influenced by the already well developed nations like France. So now here they want to check the growth of England and France, and here they want to check the growth of the German nation. So this block is automatically working against the other blocks. The enmity of one nation with the other nation added on or bounded on again and again, and became the reason for the formation of the secret alliance or secret groups for having military pacts between them. And other than this, we have another major force which is working for them, is the aggressive nationalism. The aggressive nationalism means that the countries which are like Germany, Italy have fought many wars to become united. They automatically generated themselves to feel that particular nation people are superior when compared to the other particular nation people. We started to feel that, they started to get the idea that we are of the blue race people. We have to feel that we are superior than the others. If you don't feel like that, we feel that we are inferior than others. And they feel that only their country should be the superpower country. Their country should be the ruling country. This kind of ideology was developed very keenly in the Germans by Hitler. And Mussolini has did the same with the Italy people, and made them so fanatic of their nation that they are compulsorily and forcefully made to follow certain rules and regulations and devote themselves for the nationalism. This is the concept of aggressive nationalism. Because of the ideology that every child is motivated from the childhood to get that he is superior, the other country people are inferior, and if he fight any war with anybody, he only has to win. So this kind of ideology was brought into the people, and from people it has brought into the families, from families it has brought into the nation and society, and it led to the various interlinkage of the people. And people got the ideology that instead of sitting and talking for any solution, better to do wars. If you do wars, who is victorious? That fellow will be considered as the leader of the nation. Instead of sitting and solving the disputes peacefully, everybody started to indulge themselves into the wars. This also could be one of the reasons war has been provoked by the various other people.